the render engines getting more and more similar. Is there any difference between V-Ray and Corona in 2025? The first thing, the rendering speed. I start with the times for interactive rendering. I decided to test a heavier scene so we could test properly. You can notice that Corona interactive rendering is still way quicker. It took 8 seconds for Corona to start rendering while 28 seconds for V-Ray. In the production process, it's quite a big difference, especially if you use it a lot. Another thing is that after the render starts, we can see the good quality of the image quicker in Corona, while in V-Ray, this process is slower. So definitely, Corona is a winner here. I use standard settings for both Corona and V-Ray. I tested the results after 10 minutes of rendering in high-res. In Corona, we can see lots of noise on the street even though the denoising was applied. It reached the level of noise slightly less than 12%. But we should remember that this scene has many lights and reflections, so this render may need more time for render in general. V-Ray, on the other hand, has less noise and it reached the noise threshold 0.2. So V-Ray renders faster. Here are the results for both render engines after 40 minutes. Both will need more time to render for final, but for preview, it's just fine. We could see more noise from car lights in Corona, which doesn't appear in V-Ray. But on the other hand, noise on the road looks better in Corona at this stage. In this case, the rendering for final would be quite comparable. But still, if you used optimization techniques, V-Ray would render quicker in general. Now, the frame buffer. The look is different for both, but many options are the same. In V-Ray, we have more tools like, for example, follow mouse or test resolution, where we can render a certain percentage of an original render. But the very cool new option in V-Ray that Corona doesn't have is polygon region rendering. Thanks to that, we have much more control and we can create more precise region shapes for testing. A very handy option. Most layers are very similar in the post-production panels, but they have different names. Or, for example, one layer in one render engine is broken down into a couple of layers in another one. The big difference, though, is in how the post-production process looks like. In Corona, we can add various layers, but we can only change its parameters, we cannot add masks. V-Ray works more like Photoshop. The big advantage is that we can create masks. So you can create a certain layer, adjust the settings, and then use one of the mask options to choose which area this effect should affect. Additionally, in V-Ray, we can add an image background, as well as a proportion guide, which is not a big deal for me, as I use script visible in the viewport instead anyway. We have other options in VBF that are very similar, like stats and history panel. It's just in different places. Light mix works very similarly too. We can change the intensity value and the color. Choosing colors is slightly different, but we can get the same results. So to sum up, if you want to keep your post-production only in 3D software, V-Ray will give you more possibilities. However, in Corona, we have another useful feature, the possibility of adding multiple light mix setups. So now, we can create various lighting scenarios without the need to create a separate file. If everything else stays more or less the same, of course. Basically, we have to add a new light mix render element. We can create, for instance, day and night lighting scenarios. We can create various lighting scenarios and edit just one file. The sun and sky model looks similar in both render engines. Obviously, we would have to adjust the exposure depending on the height of the sun. However, we can see that the main difference is in the horizon when the sun is on the level 0. I like the gradient the sun has close to the horizon in V-Ray. It makes it look very realistic. It looks like the V-Ray has more gradient on the sky at the moment in comparison to Corona. So I like V-Ray's sun and sky model more so far, but it's not a big difference. Some things didn't change and I don't think they will, as this is what differentiates the render engines the most. Corona is known from being user-friendly and easy to learn, while V-Ray offers more customization, especially if you want to render faster. Even though we can get very good results in both without changing any settings, V-Ray still offers more options for optimization. To make the render faster, we can change, for example, the global illumination settings. We have more control here. For instance, so far the fastest method was to choose Irradiance Map as a primary engine, but because it didn't support some of the new features, the Chaos team declared to remove it in the future. Anyway, it's still here now if you want to use it. If you want to learn more about settings in VRay, you can watch my video on this topic. The link will be in the corner and in the description. In Corona, we practically adjust only the noise limit and the noising settings. If you want to learn about Corona render settings, there is also a video for that. Another thing is that Corona is typical CPU render engine, while VRay offers CPU and GPU rendering. However, from version 12, the Chaos team included a scene export tool Vantage from Corona 2, which opens new possibilities for artists. You can now import the Corona scenes into Chaos Vantage to render test images in seconds or even create animations super fast using GPU rendering technology. Some options are in one software and we don't have it in another. We've already talked about a few. However, I wanted to include two more here. The biggest difference now will be probably the Gaussian splatting support. We have this option in VRay, but we don't have it in Corona. The results are quite impressive and it's just the beginning. It looks like it may improve a lot in the future and using Gaussian splats may become a standard step in the production process. I did a video about it in details. If you are interested, check it out. In VRay, we have another interesting option, Profiler. If you want to keep an eye on the spend time on calculating shaders and volumes, exporting scenes, compiling geometry and displacement, loading bitmaps and more. After the render is done, you can find the file in the dedicated folder. When you open it, you can find all the hotspots in your scene and optimize pipelines for even faster rendering. The last thing I want to compare is the prices. You can see the Corona is generally cheaper, no matter if we choose the solo or premium version. However, if you need 5 or more seats, then VRay has an extra type of license, which is cheaper than premium, but still more expensive than Corona. So what to choose in 2025? Corona or VRay? Look, most of the options are the same or pretty similar. It all depends on what you need and what you prefer. Both render engines give photorealistic results, but still, I personally get better outputs in Corona. However, if you prefer a more user-friendly render engine without the need to adjust advanced settings, then Corona is a better choice. Corona focuses on simplicity and getting the most realistic results, while VRay offers more adjustability and customization, which influences the rendering speed, but also gives more possibilities for tweaking. I hope this video will help you in making your decision. Whatever render engine you choose, you'll be able to get realistic and outstanding work. Good luck! Bye bye!